Maybe you should enjoy yourself. Boy, stop me, no help. They say fly girls have more fun. So what? So you should enjoy yourself. Yeah, yeah, you should enjoy yourself. It's a room full of...
It would have been rubbish. And as a mother now, I know how hard it is as a single parent. You're having to go to work and ask someone to babysit. And where's that father around?
Yeah.
This is why we're on this channel, to talk about these whatless dads, and you guys need to be put in check.
Literally. Tell them.
It's not even the gift, it's the act of calling or sending a card. Do you get me?
Yeah, literally.
I'm your child. People that ain't my parents, people that ain't even my family, will send me a card on my birthday or come give me a hug. Or do you know what I'm saying? It's your presence, not your present. Do you get me? Like, if your relationship don't work out,
it's not about
the kids. Mm-hmm. Do you get me?
That's like, what some baby fathers don't understand. They always want to get
separate the relationship from your family. Like,
just lower your tone, cause you can get hit. Man, I told you already, man. Spin that cute when we see your up boy hop out, man.
Welcome back to our channel. Right, so my name is Sarai, if you didn't know.
And my name is Aalya, for those who are just joining us.
Yes, and we have our special guest on our podcast.
Hello, I'm AA.
Yes, and this is Reality Check. So, those that ain't got their reality in check, we about to check it for you and talk about some serious stuff that's going on in our reality. As you guys can see from the title, it is all about whatless dads and growing up as a single...
In a single parent household.
With
a very absent father.
Yep. With no dad around, how was it for you guys?
At first for me, I feel like it was kind of strange having to see my mom, you know, go through all the things she was going through, and there was no support there for her. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I just felt like it was kind of strange because I was little as well, you know, you don't really know what is what and what is supposed to be. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I feel like it was kind of strange growing up, especially when you're little, like you need your family around you. Yeah, so yeah.
Similarly, yeah, I had that same sort of experience. I had my dad in my life for a while when I was little, probably until I was maybe like 3-ish. Obviously, that's if my memory serves me correctly. But my dad, it was weird. Like, there's things that I remember to this day that happened, and it just makes sense why in the end things turned out the way that they did. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So yeah, I agree that it's important that kids grow up with family around them, but 100%. Like non-toxic family members, do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
but
definitely.
Like, if anyone's innocent in that situation, it's children, do you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So yeah, what about you? What would you say is great?
For me, my mom always kind of told me how it was with my dad. Like, he was on an addiction and she left him after she had my brother. Me and my brother's like a year and a couple months apart, so yeah, it was hard. But my mom had her ex now, but boyfriend at the time, around, and he was much help, so I literally applaud him every day. Mm-hmm. Like, you was my mom's support system, because mm-hmm. without you, then it would have been rubbish. And as a mother now, I know how hard it is as a single parent. You're having to go to work and ask someone to babysit, and where's that father around?
Yeah.
Like, they should be the ones that's stepping forward.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
But it is shit, and this is why we're on this channel, to talk about these whatless dads, and you guys need to be put in check.
Literally. Tell them.
Because you can't be acting like this. You need to step up and be that person, that father figure for your child.
Yeah.
And it's like an endless cycle, because you know, a lot of people grew up in broken homes, a lot of people grew up in toxic environments. But the point is that we need to be the generation to end the cycle.
Exactly.
Because if we don't end the cycle, it's going to be the same circle of struggle and hardship over and over again. And like, coming off of what you said, like, it's just like, especially guys my dad's age and guys like my dad, they're very stubborn and they refuse to see like how they may have played a part in the reason why things to do with family and relationships went the way they turned out. And I hear a lot of bitterness sometimes from, you know, guys like that, including my own dad. And it's just like, why are you bitter for? This is the grave that you dug and now you have to lay in it. Do you get me? Don't try and pin things on my mother and blame things on my mother when I have got my own memory. Do you know what I'm saying? I've got my own memory. I saw and I experienced what I experienced. So don't try to pin things on my mother. Because she's not a saint, but she's the woman that stepped up and made sure that I grew up. Do you get me?
If it wasn't for our mums, then we would be in some foster home and stuff, and we can't look on our dad and be like, yeah, can you help me? Because what are you doing? You're just being worthless.
Yeah, and what I hate the most is the blaming part, when they actually start, you know, trying to paint a negative picture on someone that's actually being supportive. Like, it just makes it worse.
Of course. Yeah. And, you know, that's just years and bitterness and resentment that they have inside themselves for their actions. But, you know, that's just like bitterness and resentment that they have inside, that they have inside themselves for, like, the actions that they've bestowed upon their own children. And it's like, you know, we as the kids, we want to do the right thing and be there for you and that, but life has taught me to this day, like, you don't owe them nothing. Do you get me? See, my mum, she will get the world. Do you get me? And obviously, I'll be there for my dad when I need to be and make sure he's good. But, like, I don't have to be. Do you get me?
No. My whole perspective on dads now is completely changed. Because when I was growing up, I always used to be like, oh, mom, can I see my dad? Like, I love my dad. And my mom would always tell me, but your dad is not here for you. What is he doing for you? He's not even come to see you for birthdays. And that's the next topic we're going to get onto.
Oh, yeah.
He's not even there to see you for your birthday. So where are you calling him? Why are you calling his name for?
And you never understood at that time. You just
I would be like, but I want my dad.
But when you get older, you understand.
Yeah,
and they make it clear themselves, do you get me?
Yeah,
loud and clear. Like, my dad has said some very unforgivable things to me. And I'm just thinking, I'm your own child and this is how you're talking to me.
Trust me.
And you want me to believe that my mom's the villain in this story and you was the poor, sad hero. Just wanted to, you know, be a good man for the sake of his family. Alright then. Like, have some manners.
So that is the next topic we're going to get on to. No birthdays, no presents or celebrations. How was that?
Oh, that's just sad.
That's just how it was, do you hear me? Until I actually started, you know how you said it would be like, mom, I want to see my dad, Eventually, she let me see that person and my own opinion of do you get me? In them times, obviously he's got his things that he's dealing with and that plays a part into things, but at the same time, like you said, all these years when it counted, when I really wanted that sort of attention from you and all of that stuff, you weren't there really at that point where
you need your father figure the most when you're young and growing up and you just want things to be like a nice little family. But it's not like
one thing I would say is the only good thing I feel like that has come out of all of that was that you don't really remember much when you're younger, because I'm trying to think about when I was younger, what gift did my dad actually give me?
But it's not even the gift, it's the act of calling or sending a card. Do you get me?
Literally.
I'm your child. People that ain't my parents, people that ain't even my family will send me a card on my birthday or come give me a hug. Or do you know what I'm saying? It's not the gift in itself, but it's the act, the thought. Do you get me? I'm your child. Like, it's your presence, not your present.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you get me? Like, I'm your child. You should want to be there. You should want to celebrate bringing me into this world. Do you get me?
No,
but you can't force people to do things that they don't want to do. That's the simplest fact of the matter. When we were younger, we were always angry at our moms, thinking, oh, you know, why are you doing this? But the older you get, and when you see those true colors, that, you know, because like I said, my mom would say it straight how it is, but it's not like she was trying to poison us against them. She's just telling us her experience. She didn't, when I became of age, and she reintroduced me to my father, do you get me? I was of an age where I could protect myself if anything went wrong, and I could formulate my own opinions. And it just solidified all the things that I do remember from my childhood, because like you said, you don't remember everything. But I think everyone has that situation, that just situation or situations that stick out in their mind. So it doesn't matter at what an age that what age it happened, that trauma is in your mind and you can't forget that. Do you get me? And there's just instances like that, and then you sit and you wonder why you are the person that you are today. And if people like dads, worthless dads, had been involved or done the job that you're meant to do when you bring a child into this world, maybe things would have been different. Do you get me? And it's not bitterness, because obviously you can't go back and change nothing, but those are things people should have. Do you get me? A father figure, someone that they truly feel like is their dad, someone that won't say horrible things to them or do horrible. Do you get me? Like, that's what everybody deserves to have.
Yeah, I had that father figure, as I said, my mom's boyfriend at the time. He was there, but it wasn't the same. Like, for me, it wasn't the same. I always wanted my dad to be doing these things. And it wasn't that. Like, I would always want my dad to be at my school plays. That's the main thing that I kind of just remember being young and being into acting at my school plays and stuff, and want him to be there, and there wasn't. It was just my mom with her camera.
Oh, bless.
God, it's just crazy. But yeah, it's mad. Dads are crazy.
And I think that's why I think a lot of people, I'm not going to say everyone, but a lot of people, that's why we ride hard for our mums, because no matter how much they irritate us or what kind of stuff they do that just get on your nerves, they've been there for you, they've been riding for you, do you know what I'm saying? So
and
wait, exactly,
been,
so
like,
you deserve the world.
100%, I will give my mum everything.
Exactly.
There was one point why I wanted this to be the topic. It was about probably a couple of weeks ago. I kind of just broke down because I was thinking, nah, this is actually crazy. My mom has actually been through a lot, because I know that some of our generation now are trying to change that. I know a few that don't get along with their baby moms, but always want to be there for their children, which is a big move, and this is what niggas need to be doing, literally.
What we need to leave is baby moms, you know, holding their kids hostage from their baby fathers. Like, we just need to leave that alone.
At the same time, that needs to be left alone. But at the same time, like, baby dads need to be stepping up. Like,
100%.
Because there's reasons. Sometimes, I'm not saying that's acceptable, but some if a woman feels like she cannot trust the own father of her child with her kid, what is she supposed to do? What else is she supposed to do? Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's a both sides thing. Like, both people, the bitterness has to stop both ways.
Yeah.
Because I remember when I was younger, I used to always be jealous, like, and things like that. Like, or, you know, when it was, like, family day or sports day or whatever, and people would come with their dads and their mums or whatever. Do you know what I'm saying? That would always hit hard. And it's just, like, you know, I don't know how to describe it. I don't think I would say jealousy, but it was just sad. Do you know what I'm saying? To see people have what you should have, but you don't have it. And it's just like, I think just everyone needs to change anyway. Yeah. Just step up.
Literally. It's just the little things that count. As Aya's mentioned, baby mums trapping baby fathers from seeing their child. It's something that is making the baby mum want to do that, because they're not just going to want to do that
for no reason.
Simple little things, if you're just sending a £110 every day or every week, if you don't have it, like, it's the thought that counts.
Or even time, if you don't have money, then just
time.
Be there. Do you get me? Like,
but if some baby moms that trap their
baby fathers
and don't make them see their child, they can't really spend much time.
But
sending a £110
mm-hmm.
at least. That is the least.
Yeah, it will do something.
What? Let's just end that cycle altogether. Like, bro, if your relationship don't work out, it's not even about the baby mom.
It's
about the kids. Mm-hmm. To get me,
that's
like,
what some baby fathers don't understand. They always want to get
the relationship from your family. Like, this is whether you're with her or not. Have some respect for this woman.
Yeah.
This is the mother of your child. Same way, have respect for this man. He's the father of your child. I'm not saying you need to bow down backwards for them, but just have that minute bit of respect, knowing that that's the father or mother of your child. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Have a bit of respect for them. But that's what we need to break in it. At the end of the day, like, there's countless people out there that can show you that you can co-parent successfully.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the day, the only people who really suffer are the children.
Yeah.
Do you get me? Like, I might not have kids of my own, but, like, I'm the child of a situation, like, of a single mother, do you get me? So I've lived that situation, do you get me? We've lived that situation. So, and I'm sure a lot of people out there have lived that situation. And, like, we're not saying that families that, like, people that grew up in unbroken families and whatever, that, you know, their lives are all dandy and perfect. We're just saying that we wish we had that semblance of normalcy where there was a collective, like, father and mother figure, maternal figure there that we could grow up with and be taught about the world with, because that's how it's meant to be, right?
Yeah,
like,
true.
That was just
the funniest times for me.
Sometimes there was good stuff, sometimes there was bad stuff, but again, it would have just been nice to have both parents there, even if you were bad.
The discipline kind of comes in as a father figure. You're supposed to be there and want to know, like, how your child is doing at school, like, simple things. Why didn't you want to be there?
Yeah.
Like, it's not a mother's job to call you and inform you this, that.
Yeah.
You should be there. Do you get me?
Like, that's your child. And that is the main thing of this kind of subject.
Yeah.
Is these type of fathers can't separate the relationship and their child. They don't put their child in priority. They want to put the relationship that they've had with this baby mom. Okay, she's been better to me, or you don't like her, you fell out with her, whatever. And you're holding that against her for you to not want to see your child.
That's just bad line.
Yeah.
And again, like we said, it's just the cycle continuing. And then there's just going to be another child that grows up with a little empty spot inside of them that their father should have filled. And they're going to be bitter, and hopefully that child is just the one that can break the cycle, innit? Because at the end of the day, like, no child deserves to suffer for the sins of their parents, do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
At the end of the day, we're all big people. Like, when you make that decision to create a child, like, whether it's what you dreamed or not,
you've got to take responsibility. I was in these guys' positions and I didn't want to be with a baby mom or whatever, I'm here for the child.
Exactly.
I want my child to be a millionaire. Like, why am I sitting around?
I'm not gonna lie, your life would be much more simple if everyone just cooperated. Like, whether the person, baby mom, baby dad, whatever's bitter, let's just work this out for the picnic. Like, we don't even have to see each other. Just get me anything important, like, man, let you know, innit?
Yeah.
But we don't even have to see each other for more than 5 seconds. Like, do you get me? Like,
pick the child up and keep
do your thing, spend time, do you get me?
Yeah.
Like, when there's situations where you both need to be there together, i.e. parents' evening, or things like birthdays and that, like, I'm sure you can put your petty differences aside for one day and celebrate your child's birthday with no animosity, do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay, so how is your father's now, and have you pulled up your father's about how they've been throughout your childhood?
You know what I think that pisses me off about my dad when I bring up my childhood is that he just takes it back to how he was brought up.
Yeah, God.
Like, why do you have to compare?
That's, again, that's just going back to what you said, people didn't break the cycle when they used their childhood trauma, whatever, as an excuse to treat the kids the way that they were treated.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? But my relationship with my dad right now is like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I try, because obviously he has issues outside of like our problems, actual issues, that sort of affect how I look at the situation.
Mm-hmm.
But my dad has said some very unforgivable things to me, so I just think I'm at the point now where I'll just do what I need to do to make myself feel good, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to do more than what I need to do to make sure that I can just rest easily within myself and know that, do you get me? I'm just going to do the righteous thing, what I need to do, and that's it. I'm not going to do anything more than that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
well, for me, I think there was a point where my dad kind of took himself out of his addiction, went into rehab and stuff, and the rehab place was kind of coaching him to get in contact with his kids. It's just me and my brother. So we went on little camping trips and did little stuff with him, but my mum would always say before we went through the door, remember that he's only doing this because of his thing. He's not genuinely doing this. So it would always just be in the back of my mind, like, okay, we're just here because of your rehabilitation.
Your situation, yeah.
So, yeah, that would always kind of hurt me. But after that, it was known that it was just for that. We wouldn't hear from him, no contact, whatever. Then shortly after, about probably 4 years ago, he wanted to, I think he got his job and then he wanted to always give money, so that was good, but that only lasted for about 5 months. I was thinking, okay, interesting. So now I've just completely scrapped it out. Like, he's not even there. It's gone back to the same how it is. Don't communicate, nothing. So now I just kind of think, there's no point of having you in my life. I can't even call on you to ask you for a helping hand. There's no point.
And one thing we're even forgetting is that things like that, they have such deep effect on us. And like, it's so traumatic. Like, if the littlest things are so traumatic and traumatizing to people. Like, people are different, but there are kids up there where it really affects them to the stage where, you know.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of my anxiety and, you know, other issues stem from times, like, not all of them, but a lot of them stem from times where I was staying with my dad and dealing with certain things. And it's just like, realizing that, I don't know, that your mental health has just been made fragile by this person that you should be able to trust and expect the world from. Do you know what I'm saying? And then you come to that realization and it's just like, I don't know, like, I want to work on myself and come out of that rut. Do you get me? But at the same time,
not a lot of people are gonna feel like that.
That's shaped me into the person that I am now. It shaped me into how I react, how I carry myself, everything. It's shaped who I am now, because like you said, it has an effect on you. Do you know what I'm saying? So yeah, man, like you said, man, it's just like, things can be good for a while with your dad, because that's how it was for me. Things are good for a while, then he will just be unreasonable about something small and stupid and say horrible things and expect me to just stand there and take it. Like, this is one thing that people need to realize, that whether it's your family member, friend, whatever, you don't need to deal with people who are gaslighters and who are abusers and who are just toxic. Like, you don't need to. You can literally just
separate,
snip, snip, burn that bridge, cut it off. Like, do you get me? Like, you literally don't have to deal with it. And I'm at that point in my life now where if anybody comes to me with some pasta pasta that I'm not interested in, I'm not dealing with it, because I don't have to. I can walk away. I've got 2 feet. Do you get me? My mind's intact. I can walk away. Like, 2020, I think, was just a hard year for everybody, and it put a lot of perspective, it put a lot of things in perspective for me personally, and I'm sure a lot of other people were enlightened. And it just made me come to the realization that, bruh, like, putting yourself first is paramount. Do you get me? Making sure that you're good and you and yours is good first is paramount. Don't let these people with their bad, negative, bad vibes bring you down. Like, we're all grown people. I don't want to argue. I don't want to fight. I'm just going to keep it moving. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, trust me.
Well, the last thing, guys, is if your father was to change now, what would you say?
Do you know what, yeah?
That is such a funny
question. When you're not the way that they're meant to be during your formative years,
yeah,
there's no point changing and coming to me now when I'm a woman, do you get me? Yeah, because your time is gone. Your time gone. Do you get me? At this point, I'm a woman who's lived through things,
yeah,
who's had her own experiences,
mm-hmm,
who's
probably
seen,
doesn't
do you get
need
me?
Your support as much. Yeah.
Exactly. Like, I may only know 2% of everything that's in this world, mm-hmm, but it's still 2% more than I knew back then. Do you get me?
Yeah.
So, boy, like, even if he was to change, I'm not gonna be like some bitch. Do you get me?
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't change what's happened in the past. Do you get me?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not gonna forget. And I'm not going to dedicate my life to you either.
Yeah.
Simple as.
Yeah. But with me, because my relationship with my dad, from where I see it, I try to see it in a way that, you know, no matter what he does to me, I try to see it as his way of showing his love. Like,
mm-hmm,
that's the only... It is showing me what he knows. He can't show me anything he doesn't know.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a thing where I have to, you know, just... understand that, you know, it is what it is, and you know, if he actually changes, I will be so happy, because my dad, I feel like he has a loving personality inside all of his shenanigans, but so it's like I'll be so just so excited just to have to start building whatever relationship I can build with him, really.
That's good for you.
Yeah.
I won't be excited at all, because it's broke me, and now being a parent as well, it's like, I know what heartache and strain it is being a mother without that father there, so...
Yeah. It helps you see things from a different perspective than just as a child.
Literally, you guys will soon see it. So,
listen,
but it's crazy.
Me.
Well, I don't want to say that soon, see it, but I hope you guys get a good guy, but boy...
Yeah. All I'm saying is, yeah, the behaviour that our dads displayed, if you was to be with a man and he was to treat you that way, the way that our dads treated our mums and everything that we went through, you wouldn't have it. So just because you're my dad does not mean I'm going to have it.
Yeah.
Do you get me? Because no man that I'm laying with could do that to me.
Yeah,
so
literally.
Why should my own dad be able to get away with it when he should be the example of what kind of man I should be looking for? Do you get me?
Yeah,
so that's the way I kind of try to see things in perspective.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get me? I'm not going to be sitting here and blaming him for this and that,
mm-hmm,
whether or not like absence or the way he was acting or things he said had an effect. I'm not going to, because at the end of the day, we're all in charge of our own choices. No matter what influenced them, we all are in charge of our own choices.
Yeah.
But like I said, like you said, like at this point, the only person that you need to forgive is yourself for feeling that heartache, for feeling that pain, for going through that sadness and the hatred of yourself and the depression and the anxiety. Forgive yourself.
It's a lot.
No cap. We were kids, do you get me? We were kids. We're just babies right now, like, do you get me? We're still just baby girls, like, we were kids. Forgive yourselves.
Yeah.
Because, like you said, fam, I had a day where I just broke down too, and I was just like, why? And I'm just thinking, why the fuck am I blaming myself? I've only been here for 23 years. Like the fuck?
Here.
I ain't been here that long to be feeling like this. Do you get me? And I was like, do you know what? People always tell you, forgive that person, but never forget. Fuck that, that's bullshit. You don't need to forgive nobody that's done you wrong. The only person you need to forgive is yourself for feeling upset, or for feeling sadness, or for feeling depression. Or, do you get me? The only person you need to forgive is yourself. Because, like, they don't care if they're hurting you. So when you're feeling all these things, you're just locking yourself up into them feelings, and you're hurting yourself. Forgive yourself. We're allowed to feel. We're allowed to feel sadness, anger, happiness, love, pain. We're allowed to feel. Don't, like, do you get me? Forgive yourself. Don't give these people your energy. If someone hurts you, it's not for you to forgive them. Do you get me? Like, it's for you to forgive yourself and forget about them blood clot forever. Don't think about them again.
The only way I would let him in is for his grandchildren, but even that, I don't want him there. There's no point. But
the crucial times are over, basically.
Yeah, and I don't know how I feel about all of that making up for it by being a good grandparent, car Where was all of that when I was growing up?
Where
like,
was
where
the
was
energy?
It?
Where was it?
Where was it? And all of a sudden now you want to be the world's favorite people? I don't think so.
No, that's the only way I was thinking you could make it up. Just make it up to them. But I still feel hurt.
Yeah.
But that's
and you're entitled to feel hurt. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, people changing. Yeah, okay, that's good and that's fine. And yeah, if you feel like somebody deserves a second chance, then give it to them. Mm-hmm. But just because someone changes does not take away the fact that they hurt you or they caused you pain. Do you get me? It does not take that away. So yeah, all you have, you can forgive other people if you want to, but just make sure that you forgive yourself as well, innit?
Well guys, that is it from us. I hope you guys got something from this. If you are a father that's listening to this as well, and you know that you want to make a change and just be there for your child, this is your reality check. Come on.
Step up, man. And at the end of the day, it's only our community that continues to suffer, isn't
it? Yeah, absolutely.
Standard.
Yeah.
So yeah, guys, just a little bit of food for thought.
And send this to your fathers if you want. Let them know this is how a broken girl feels.
Yeah.
Yeah, if anyone has any similar experiences, feel free to let us know. Obviously, we can only speak on a female's perspective.
Yeah.
Well, we can. Obviously, you have your own experiences that you can speak on, but we can only speak on a female perspective. So, we'd be interested to know what anybody else thinks. Mm-hmm. You know, he, she, they, them, whoever.
Yeah.
Let us know how you're feeling in the comments.
And there's loads more topics coming up, guys, and male company as well. So you'll get the male perspective.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But stay tuned for more reality check.
Bye.
Do you know your love language?
Yeah, money. No, I'm joking.
She knows. That is my love language.
Do you know what? My love language, I like receiving gifts and I like words of affirmation. And also, I just like intelligent conversation. Someone that they know me, I like debate. So if you come to me with some sort of debate and we can be talking for hours about something, I love that.
To know your spiritual
energies.